Welcome to this Star Talk Games, little boy. We got live streams and gameplays, little boy. Level up, Super Mario. Get crazy, man, Wario. We about to take over the whole planet. But my time is running out, so you better check the channel. We got a lot of information, let's get it. You want all that information? Come get it.
Hi gamers, how are you doing? I hope you're doing fine. Welcome to Sajan News. In today's video, I'm going to cover the PlayStation 5 rumors. So let's talk about the PlayStation 5. I'm also going to give you my opinion about it. So when will this console release? How many will it cost? How powerful will it be? Let's discuss. The rumors is saying that the PS5 will be 14.2 teraflops. Sounds powerful. More than two times more powerful than the Xbox One X. And it will have a GPU from Navi, a Navi GPU. So the new one from AMD. CPU is AMD, of course, based on 8 core and will be a Zen CPU. Memory, 32GB GDDR6. Also a new memory, but 32GB sounds powerful, sounds crazy, sounds a lot. 1TB SSD hard disk drive. That doesn't sound like much. I mean, if you look at how powerful this console will be, this machine means more and bigger games. So you need more space. So 1TB doesn't sound much. So okay, how crazy will the thing cost? I mean, those specs is crazy for a console. I mean, 4 teraflop to 6 teraflop and now 14.2 teraflops. Did you see the jump there? This is going to be insane. Of course, this is going to be powerful. This looks like the future. This is the next step. Sony like to do that. But what does 14.0 teraflops means? I mean, 6 teraflops is doing, some games are doing 4K 60 frames per second. So with 14 teraflops, does this console need 14 teraflops to do real 4K in 60 frames per second with every games? I think that 12 teraflops is great and good enough. So where is the 14.2 teraflops from? Of course, these are rumors, but it can be true. And 32GB GDDR6 memory. Wow, man, that sounds too crazy to me. Why so much? The only thing I can say about this is DevKit. This is for developers. That's the reason why it is this much. Okay, but let's discuss what I think the final product will be. What will be in the final PS5 product in the machine? I think, to be honest, around 12 teraflops. But 14.2 teraflops is also possible. Yeah, that one is also possible. And the CPU? Yeah, I don't know what to think about CPU, but 8 core, a Zen CPU, everything is possible about CPU. The memory, 32GB. Nah, I don't believe that this will be in the final product. Not that much. At least, if maybe Sony want to do 8K. But come on, 8K. 4K is not standard yet. So why 8K? So, no. 32GB, no way. The final product will have, I think, 16GB. Yeah, 16. That's what I think, 16GB. Okay, 1TB hard disk. That is not much. If Sony is going to have a powerful machine, so how big will the games be? 100GB? Maybe 150GB? So that means 1TB is not much. It's not enough, Sony. So at least 4 terabyte is needed. If this console is going to be that powerful. And to be honest, I believe that it's going to be that powerful. At least 12 teraflops. At least. So 1 terabyte? No, man, that's not much. That's not enough. That's not enough. No, Sony, that's not enough. We need more. When will this console release? 2018? This year? No, I don't believe that. Why? Okay, let me give you a couple of reasons why I think it won't release this year. If these specs are true, if those specs are true, it will be too expensive to release this year, next year, also in 2020. That's one. The second one. Look at the games I show you in this video. So many great games to come are going to release on the PlayStation 4. So why hurry, PlayStation? Why hurry, Sony? Why hurry, PlayStation? I mean Sony. Sony, don't need to hurry. Take your time. Look how many great games you have. And the PS4 is selling way better than the Xbox X. So Sony, don't need to hurry. Take your time, Sony. You have so many great games coming. The PlayStation will keep selling. So PS5 this year? No, that won't happen. No. Next year? No. Maybe 2019, at the end of 2019, is possible. Yes, that's possible. At least. But to be honest, the right spot is 2020. Yes, that's my opinion. The right spot is 2020, Sony. So many great games coming. And this PlayStation is keep selling, and it will keep selling, so we don't need to hurry. Let Xbox make the first move, and then you make your move. Why do I think that? Because you have so many great games coming and you are selling like hotcakes. So Sony, PlayStation 5 this year, don't think about it. Next year, at the end, maybe. But the right spot is 2020. But I like that this console is going to be powerful, man. I don't like only power, to be honest. But the reason why I say I like that this console is going to be powerful is because I know with power they can do more than only graphics. New things. That maybe the AI will be smarter. And we need that kind of, we need something new in the game industry. I mean, every game's almost the same, so we need that. We need more power to do more. And I'm not talking about graphics. I mean, look at how great those games you're seeing right now. They are great. They are fine already. It looks crazy already. So I think that the PlayStation 5 will release in 2020 with a 500 price point. It will release for 500, maybe maximum $600. That's what I think. And will release in 2020. That's what I bet. So let me know your opinion. Let me know when you think the PlayStation 5 will release, and how much it will cost, and how powerful it will be. Guys, thank you for watching. Have a great day. Take care. Peace.
Thanks for watching. Thanks for your time. Thumbs up for the video. Comment and subscribe. You better hit the button. Come and follow the tribe. With every few of love. So I'll see you next time. Let's get it on.